Well, hello there. It's that time again. Yes, it is, my friend. It has rolled around again this week. Time for the blog that truly blazes here on this kind of windy but now becoming sunny Sunday here in South Florida, January the 17th. And as usual, I will go over the energies of the end of last week's reading, what we got coming up now, and what lies ahead of us at the end of this upcoming week. So do stay tuned. Again, another interesting ride. Yes, the first card is the last card of the previous week's reading, and this card was the Queen of Wands. Ooh, very fiery, very powerful Leo energy. See, you may have felt very strong these last few days. You may have felt more enthusiastic, more energy coming out of you. Leo is very projective, very proud. It is ruled by the sun, and the sun is spiritual success, freedom, and a feeling of expansion. So you may have felt some of this over the last few days. Yes, we are still in Mercury retrograde, but that's okay. I haven't felt too many effects from it. Some communication glitches here and there, knock on wood. It's not going to be too problematic, and I hate to harp on Mercury retrograde, but I feel I have a responsibility to mention it because it's not a time to sign contracts, make major purchases if we can avoid them, or major long-term commitments. This is more of a time for cleaning up the past, taking care of projects we have not finished. That's an excellent use of this time and this energy. And as we're going to see, though, this is going to be a pleasant week as long as we're focusing on things from the past and slowly but surely building up our financial picture and our resources. That's right. The card for the present, what we're coming into now, is the Eight of Discs or Pentacles. Now, this is entitled Prudence, and it's attributed to Sun in Virgo. This is a very pleasing energy. This is working. This is putting together the finances carefully. Virgo likes to analyze. It's ruled by Mercury. So a good use for these Mercury energies, even in retrograde, is going over the past carefully, looking at where we're coming from, perhaps financially, what our goals are, what we're trying to accomplish, so we can assemble them towards the future. Now, the moon this week is doing some things that kind of correspond with our reading. The moon right now, as I speak, is coming out of Aries, going to be going into Taurus, which is a fixed earth sign, okay, fitting in with that energy of the Eight of Pentacles. Then it's going to go into Gemini around the middle of the week, and then it's going to wind up being in Leo at the end of the week with the full moon, as we're going to see as we get into this reading. But just know for now, it's good to settle in, take care of your financial picture. You know, we all kind of can get a little haywire during the holidays, so you might be getting some of those credit card bills or looking at what you've done. It's okay. It's just time to grow slowly, be careful, conservative. If we do that, we're going to be on top of things by the end of this upcoming week, as you'll see in the next card. That's right. The next card, the card for the end of the week, is the Princess of Discs or Page of Pentacles in the Rider-Waite system. Now, this is a very pleasing card. This is a female energy that stands tall on her own 2 feet, has control of her finances, a very, very powerful person. And this is where we can be. We can be sitting fairly pretty towards the end of this upcoming week if we're careful, if we're looking at what we're doing, if we're following the lessons of Virgo and proper use of the Mercury retrograde energy. We can be in a fairly good position, okay? Not your finances are going to change overnight, but your attitude towards them can. And we can feel more rooted, we can feel more grounded, and ready to manifest some good things, because we do have a full moon coming up this next Saturday. Yay! Nice full moon energy. It's moon in Leo. Now, this can be interesting. The moon in Leo can kind of stir up the emotions, all right? Could stir us up emotionally to a degree, could bring some things up, again, maybe from the past, as part of retrograde energy, but it's good stuff. It's cleansing. It can be empowering. And with this Princess of Discs or Page of Pentacles, this to me says that we are going to be achieving something significant, that we're going to feel more grounded, more alive, more vibrant, more in control, by the end of this upcoming week. And, by the way, we have the Sun entering Aquarius. I almost forgot. Oh, I like that. I'm an Aquarius, okay? So I like it when the Sun enters Aquarius. That's a big vitalizing point for yours truly. That's going to be happening this Wednesday, just so you know. Well, there you go. The blog blaze, you blazed along with it. Thanks a lot for your support. I really appreciate it. I love you. Thanks for watching this blog. Till I see you next week, many, many blessings.